Thank you. Hello, everyone. Is this working? Awesome. What's happening? How's it going? Good? Great? Woo! All right. Fantastic. I just want to say a little something about this song. Actually, the last song was named, was called Bridgetown because I lived in Brooklyn for a long time. Just moved back to Los Angeles. I'm from LA about 2 years ago. But there are a lot of West Indians in my neighborhood, and I used to hear that calypso rhythm that Doug was playing almost every day for 15 years. So I thought I'd write a tune about it. But this song is called Sonnet for Stevie, and yeah, it's a little bit about growing up in Southern California. I'm from Los Angeles, and I grew up in the 70s. And my parents used to do something that maybe you don't do here in Germany, maybe you do, but on the weekends, they would go out and get really excited about looking at property. Do you guys do that? Is that a thing here? So it's a thing. In Southern California, they were building tract homes, and the further out you went, it was still kind of like, it's actually like ranch land, and where I grew up, there was still the remnants of ranches from the 19th century, and then their tract homes being built. And so they get excited about going to these places where, you know, there's maybe five houses, and there are all these different versions of them in a big neighborhood. So, you know, one of them has, the entryway is rectangular, but it's the same house. The other one is maybe, rounded. Sometimes the house is a mirror of another house. Sometimes same house, but stucco instead of clapboard, something like that. Anyway, so we'd go, and it would be the whole afternoon. My parents would be super stoked. They'd go with their friends. They'd be checking out all these houses and stuff. And, you know, this is maybe 1975. I was 9 or 10, and I was like, oh, my God, can we go home, right? I was super bored, and it was just me, no other kids. And they were super excited, and, you know, so it was a total drag. But the best part was going home. So my parents were cool. They had what did they drive? They drove a 1974 maroon Volvo sedan. I think it was pretty awesome. And yes, pretty happening. And they smoked still. You're not supposed to smoke, but it's kind of cool, you have to admit. Right? I mean, so, you know, and my dad had lots of music. So he played, mostly R&B, some jazz, and he had piles of tapes in his tape deck. And so he played fantastic music on the way home. So, you know, it would be like, you know, Otis Redding, The Spinners, Al Green, Marvin Gaye, who else? The OJs, you know, a bunch of people like that. And Stevie Wonder, of course. And my favorite tune coming home, usually around 3 or 4 in the afternoon after super boring looking at property. it's California's great. It was sunny all the time, and you've seen movies in the 70s, at least ones that are made in California. Everything looks the same. The sun is always this beautiful kind of yellow, mellow kind of, everything's going to be fantastic for the rest of the world and the rest of your life kind of vibe. And that's what it was like. And so they play these great songs. And one song I really loved going home was Blame It on the Sun by Stevie Wonder. And this song is sort of based on that. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for having both Mark and myself here in your amazing country of culture, music, love, and life. It's been a beautiful experience for me to be able to work with this amazing outfit for the first time. These are a wonderful group of musicians to really get into some creation, and very inspired by this whole thing. So thank you so much for having us. You just heard Mark's piece, Brother, Sister 2, which he wrote about his kids, which I think is amazing. Very complex children, I think. upbringing with Mark. It's just a joy to get to know Mark and his music. I'm in it with you. And we're going to close this set now with another piece of his. This is called Nigeria 2. And then we're going to take a small break and come back with more. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm back at the mic again. Imagine that. So that last song was called A Lenny Groove, and I wrote it a long time ago, maybe in the mid-90s, something like that. I was highly influenced by Lenny Tristano and Warren Marsh, Lee Konitz at that time. And so I wanted to write a melody that, or a song that they would never play, but sounds like them. So, because they always played on standards, they didn't write original tunes. So, and they never played, they always played in four. That's true, there's nothing in three, yeah. So anyway, that's it. This one is called Walking Ballad and has never been played live before an audience until now, right? Yes, arranged by Christine Jensen. Killed it. All right, let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We're coming to the end of this amazing, precious evening of music. Before we do our last piece, I get to introduce the band. So forgive me in advance for my very bad German. I'm going to work on it. I'm good at French, not German, so it will come. We're going to do the saxophones first, starting with our leader, Heinz-Dieter Sauerborn, on the soprano and alto and all these things. Sauerborn. Oliver Leicht on the left of him, Stefan Weber, Dennis Goebel, the tenors that have to be with Mark here, and Rainer Hoyt holding us down. Move on to the trombones. We have, starting over on the bass trombone, Robert Hedman, then Christian Juxur. See, this is terrible. Felix Fromm on second, and Gunther Bullman on the lead. And your mighty trumpet section, we have, I'm going to go backwards again. You've heard a bunch of solos from him. He's just wonderful. Axel Schlosser on the fourth trumpet and soloist. Martin Auer on third. Our newest friend, Felix Meyer on second. And who I love to sing along with the most, we have Frank Vellert on the lead. And then all the beautiful sounds of the rhythm section. We have Hubert Nuss on the piano and the Rhodes. And Martin Scales on the guitar. One of my oldest friends ever, I met him when I was 17 in Copenhagen. We have Doug Weiss on the bass. It wasn't that long ago. You're lucky because now he's part of Germany and he's living in Berlin, so you win. And we have holding us down and doing a marvelous, just so much energy, Jean-Paul Hochstadter on the drums. Thank you to all the wonderful people who have brought myself and Mark here, and especially a big thank you again to Jim McNeely for putting trust in me to stand in front of this amazing band and also to somehow learn Mark's music. And now I'm going to go practice my saxophone because of it. Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Would you like one more? We might have one more for you. Once again, Mark Turner and the HR Band. And you just heard that piece was called It's Not All Right With Me. And now we're going to do... We still have one more because Jim McNeely did all this beautiful arranging of music. And we seem to have a plethora of beautiful arrangements of Mark's music. So here we go, one more.
This one's called Lincoln Heights. And Lincoln Heights is it's kind of a little township outside of Cincinnati, Ohio, where my dad grew up. And so this is about him.